what a difference a day makes. Yesterday on this hole, I went straight behind into the water with the very same ball I'm using today, which nicely floated and we got out, but I ended up with a 7. This one I've just struck so perfectly and landed. I'm not quite sure how near the pin it is, but it's not that far. It's probably about 10 feet. And I'm going really well. I'm 3 under bogey par so far after 4 holes. So doing very nicely. And really enjoying it. Oh, actually, I'm nearer than I thought, maybe. It's difficult, still difficult to tell. It looks like it's quite close. So weird, because back there, as I just said, I thought it was about 10 feet from the hole, but very nicely played. Instead, I'm a single foot from the hole. So in one hole, I've just shaved 5 shots off yesterday's round. So I don't know how often I've done that, but it means after the first five holes, I'm actually at par. I probably have done it before, but it'll be in the very low ones. Yeah, simply because of the two first holes. So to do it, you have to get 5s on the first holes, followed by par, birdie, birdie, which is what I've just done. certainly a bit of adrenaline in that shot, as it's gone longer than I thought. Difficult to tell where it is in relation to the pin. But yeah, so currently I'm on 7 under against bogey par after 7 holes, so still at par. I think my best on this course is on the front nine is 7 under bogey par, so 2 over par. I'm not 100% certain. I just don't think I ever got 8 under against bogey par. It's a golden opportunity, but whatever happens now, the main thing is I'm having a very good round, and certainly looking at a ball keeper at minimum at the moment. Okay, it's in a good position. Such a sensible shot. I knew it was unlikely that I'd clear the bunker, so I went for safety instead. So I've now got to get up and down to par the course, or the front nine. Amazing, that's the first time I've used the club since the round before last. So it's such a pity about that fluff shot, but I've just scored a 6, so I'm only 1 over par for the round, and that is my record front 9 at Unico. It's obviously disappointing, but it's only disappointing because I didn't par the front 9. It is, of course, a wonderful example of how golf is, that you can feel disappointed when, after what must be a couple of hundred rounds on this course, I've just got my record front 9 and I'm still disappointed. But that's the nature of the beast. But how fantastic, I've just done the front 9 in 35, so I've got to really, really keep concentrating now, because I could of course get a record score now, but definitely on for a very good one anyway, so let's see how good it can be. That was amazing because I scuffed it, landed on the path, and then pitched really high and it's gone to the back of the green. So a complete fluke. Came down here, bounced on the path, and went straight up in the air at the pin. Landed just by the pin, then rolled up to the back. worse and worse. Well, horrendously, after going so well, I'm now still only 10 under bogey par. And it means that, okay, I can bogey par the next two holes and get a ball keeper, but to get 69, I've got to do two pars. And at one stage, I was looking at getting 66, 67. So the pressure's on. What's amazing is that on the front nine, I was minus eight against bogey par, and I've only added minus two in seven holes on the back nine. So yes, disappointing in the end, as I only got a 70, but it is a ball keeper, first ball keeper for a while, and I shouldn't forget that I got my record front nine at Unico today of one over par, eight under bogey par, 35, exactly what I got on the back nine.